Hello, Passport member. How clever are you for being a Passport member and getting to see how I made this photo? All right. By the way, hot tip. Not really hot tip. I wore this very stylish sweatshirt the other day on a live broadcast. I got lots of questions. Where'd you get that sweatshirt? It's from Uniqlo, U-N-I-Q-U-O. It's a European store. It's kind of like The Gap, but they make like better clothes than The Gap. And it's quite inexpensive, and they ship to the U.S. There's stores in the U.S. too. Okay, you're not here for fashion. You're here to see how I made this photo. Now, you have already seen the final version. And in a sense, you have an advantage over me because I have not seen the final version. I have not made it yet. Okay, but I can tell it's going to be a tough one. It's going to be challenging. So I'm going to kind of walk through it here the way I usually do. You know, in these little tutorials, I have this sort of philosophical approach. And I kind of talk through my thoughts. It's very Bob Rossian, my homage to Bob Ross. Okay? And if you enjoy this kind of thing, please tell your friends. You know, the more the merrier. Get them in. Get them to be Passport members. And it's a great gift. Great gift. Okay. Now, let me talk about this export. This is an older photo that I shot with my Nikon, I think. I could probably look at the EXIF, but I just feel like it's a Nikon shot for some reason. I exported these five photos as JPEGs. Okay, let me show you the five photos. Dark to bright, okay? Now look at this. The observant eye will notice that these lupins are flying around like a college student on a pole, okay? That needs money. Not all college students. You know, you get the idea. The point is that there's a lot of movement, okay, in a spiral motion. So this is going to be a problem, right? So what I've done is I've exported all these images, and when I put them into an HDR, a single HDR, if I don't turn on ghosting, there's going to be a problem, okay? But I'm going to do an experiment, and you can experience the experiment with me, and it is this. Besides these five photos, I've exported an additional one. Okay, you might notice that this one is an NEF file down here. So I took the middle exposure and exported it as a RAW. So first I'm going to try combining five shots, actually three. We'll leave out the middle ones, I'll show you. And compare that result to a single RAW file. I'm not sure which will be best. Oftentimes I do find the original RAW is better. Now this is great because it's faster. And simpler, okay? Occam's razor, simplest is always better, okay? So now, instead of putting all five photos in, I'm just gonna put the darkest, middle, and brightest. These other ones, they don't add information, they just slow it down, all right? So let's drag these into Aurora. Depending on when you see this, Aurora for Windows may be available. If not, soon, okay? We're working out as fast as we can. And if you're using Photomatics, a lot of these same techniques apply, all right? So I'm gonna click alignment. And if you're a Passport member, by the way, you have the whole new HDR tutorial where I show all new techniques in Photomatics, okay? Alignment, yes. Additional settings, turn on ghosting, and we want it to be the middle exposure. And we'll turn up the amount to high because there's a lot of movement, okay? A lot of pole dancing going on. Okay, so I'll say create HDR, okay? Here, let's change to one of my favorite new songs. Which one is it? Is it this one? Or is it this one? Oh, yeah. This is from Moonrise Kingdom, one of my favorite movies from Wes Anderson. Music is important when you're editing photos, for me. I switch it around. Get ready. Fast forward. What a tune. It's not like an old timer, but they don't make songs like this anymore. Okay. All right, we're ready. Let me turn down my music. Focus. Whoa. All right. It's looking quite electric, isn't it? Quite bright. By the way, this is shot in Tekapo, New Zealand, a classic place for these lupins. I think the ghosting did a pretty good job. Pretty good job. So what we'll do here is we'll kind of take this one all the way through to its fini. Okay, I'll do my best I can with this one. And then we will play with the other one. Okay. So because we brought in multiple exposures, we'll do this HDR look. Let's play with this. Let's drop that down. I like that it made it a little more contrasty. And watch this, when I pull it up, I think everything will look a little bit fluorescent. And see that? It's an okay look, you know, if you want that kind of look. It's interesting, very painterly, very bright. I'm going to bring it down a little bit, though, like this, okay? And I feel like there's not enough shadow in here, so I'm going to pull up the contrast a little bit. See how this brought some depth into that, into the dark spots behind the lupins. That's looking very nice, isn't it? Very nice. Very nice. By the way, point of interest, I shot this at f/16, which means stuff close to me is in focus and stuff far away from me is in focus, which is only a factor when you're shooting wide angle stuff. Okay. I don't use smart tone too much. Let me just look at it. Yeah, see, it's kind of undoing those shadows that I made. So just these two things, HDR look and contrast, you can see what a difference it's made. Just made it a little bit more punchy. Looking good. Looking good, feeling good. Awesome. You know, that by itself is pretty good. Let's just look at a before and after. Before, middle exposure, after. Better, eh? Look at that. Which makes you happy. It is bright. It is brighter. But that's okay. Let's try a few other things here, okay? Let's try a few other things, shall we? I'm going to add a layer. Adjustment layer. And in a way, by the way, comparing this one to the raw file will be apples and oranges because I will inevitably have a slightly different technique. Okay. Oftentimes on the next layer, what I'll do is I'll just play with HDR structure. So I'm going to increase the structure here and drop down the softness, which makes it a little sharper. Okay, ooh, look at that, nice and sharp. Now I'll pick my brush, and I'll just go over some of these lupins in the foreground to make them even sharper. Okay. Oh yeah, look at that, sharpen them up. Sharpen them up. All these, get them nice and sharp. Sharpie sharp, yeah. Now watch, what's gonna be interesting is in a moment I'm gonna make them less sharp by adding a bit of glow, okay? So this is kind of stage one. Okay, if you want to see what I just painted, that's kind of the area I just painted in, okay? Nice. Now, I'm going to add an adjustment layer, and now I'm gonna add some glowy glow in. Some image radiance. I really don't need to increase my smart colors, but you can see if you do this, it makes it like, whoops. It makes it really glowy, right? Which you might want to go for. Sometimes I do like that glowy look, and actually I do like a little bit here, but not that much. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make it quite high, pick my brush, and just brush in a few areas where I like it. Okay, I'll be a little bit random where I do it. Out there in the distance is nice. Maybe some of these in the foreground. Okay. It also makes the shadows even shadowier. So you want to see where I just painted? Kind of a little randomly around here, okay? You can turn on and off the layer to see what it did. Just adds a little bit of romance in there, okay? Now let's play with the sky. I really haven't... Let's look at the original sky and the new sky. So the new sky is a little bit better. It's already been HDR'd a little bit, you see? Maybe I won't touch it. I think I might... Oh, I have an idea. Let's do this. Even though this is a new feature in HDR 2017, I haven't been using it much. It is called... Let me get rid of the presets here. It is called the Polarizer. Polarizing filter. And what it does is it takes the blue sky and darkens it up a little bit. So that's a lot. It's too much. We're going to just do it a little bit here. Yeah, look at that. Come on, it's already better. Let's do a little denoise because I see a little bit of noise and noise up there. Cool. And then I'll just brush it into the sky. And because I shot at f/16, I see a few little marks on my sensor. What can I tell you? I'm riding dirty, white and nerdy with my sensor. It's true. I can't deny it. Gosh, this is looking good. I like this photo. I like it a lot. Okay, good. I think I'm done. Right? Pretty good. So let's look at it before. Right out of the camera. Wah, wah. After. Oh, let's do one more thing. I think the flowers are beautiful, very colorful, but they're colorful everywhere. And sometimes what I like to do is have a transition from a less colorful to more colorful, from less HDR to more HDR. So I'm going to make another layer here, and I'm going to desaturate it. Okay, drop down the saturation. And then I'm going to get my brush. Okay, and then I'm just going to brush a little bit here on the sides. Like, see this pink one? Make it a little less bright. It's starting a little bit less saturated on the outside and moving to more saturated on the inside. Okay, so you can see where I painted here, just kind of on the outside, transitioning in. Nice, even better. All right, once again, before, after. Great. Export to image. I put it in my processing folder because I still need to get it into Photoshop and do a few adjustments. Okay. So this is an experiment that anyone can do. You guys can do it too. I often get asked, is it better to do multiple exposures or a single exposure? I'm like, I don't know. Six in one, half a dozen in the other. So now that I've finished processing these, I'm going to hit delete. Okay, they're still back in my Lightroom. And we're going to drag this one into Lightroom. All right, I'm sorry, into Aurora as well, as soon as this thing's done. So some of you might notice I'm using a Mac right now. I'm only using the Mac for Aurora, okay? And what I do in Lightroom is everything that I think deserves some Aurora treatment, like this one, I export them to a Dropbox JPEG, which gets replicated right here to this directory called AuroraMe. So I jump on my Mac, you know, a couple times a day and process some photos. Sort of one of my meditations. Okay, I don't want to save that. HDR will be made from this, okay? And I'll set additional settings. There should be no noise. I don't need to turn that on. I'll do the CA thing. Chromatic aberration, create HDR. Now in this case, there's no need to choose any ghosting options because it's just one image, so there's no chance of that. And on the previous image, I never zoomed into 100%. There might be a little blurring in there, but we'll check later, okay? One reason I don't check a lot in Aurora, because when you zoom into 100%, it's just a little slow, and it's to re-render everything, okay? I have a feeling you did a pretty good job, you know, close enough for government work, as they say. Now, here's one thing to notice with a single RAW. Right away, when I go up here and click before and after, it's the same. It makes no adjustment. When you do multiple images, it will make some initial HDR moves, okay? So nothing is done here. So you really have to amp it up here, okay? So let's start with the contrast a little bit here. Let's do a little bit of overall vibrance. Okay, maybe a little smart tone to bring up those shadows. Okay, already looking a little better, eh? A little better. So just look at it before and after already. A little brighter, a little happier. And again, look, I go to the ropes with these things. I go hardcore, and I really bend these things to my will. For a lot of you, this may be good enough. Look, it's quite an improvement already, all right? So anyway, now I'm going to hit plus, adjustment layer. And now I'm really going to work on the HDR-ness of it, okay? So I'm going to go here to HDR structure, increase this. Aw, yeah. Maybe, now decision, you want soft flowers or hard flowers? Last time I went hard. I think I'll, to stay consistent, I'll still go a little bit hard like that. Okay. And I will increase the vibrance because I'm just playing with the flowers here. And a little bit of smart tone to get those shadows up. Good. Now I'm just going to brush in over the flowers. And this should make the flowers even better. Even brighter. More happy. Happy little flowers. Look at these things. Gorgeous. Look at these colors. The whites, the pinks, the peaches, the lilacs. The fuchsias. Amazing. What a world we live in. What a earth that grows this kind of crazy stuff. Beautiful. Okay, that's looking good. Now let's work on the sky. Okay, adjustment layer. Let's do a little bit of HDR structure, a little bit of softness. Okay, we're getting a little banding in the sky there, so let's lower that. A little denoise, a little smooth. Let's add a little radiance, a little smart colorize, a little polarizing filter. There we go. Now that sky's looking pretty dreamy, isn't it? So let's paint in that nice sky. Painting in the sky, painting in the sky. Looking good. Now let's add a little vibrance, or not vibrance, image radiance down below. Okay, we'll give it a little of that glowy glow. So image radiance, a little bit of smart colorize, and a little bit of brightness. Okay, now I'll start kind of randomly painting in these flowers. Okay, randomly painting in the flowers. I'll show you my mask after this. So where did I paint? Kind of around there. Make that part a little bit more glowy. Then I'll do the same thing as last time, where I'll make an adjustment layer and desaturate the outside so that the transition is a little bit more subtle. Okay. Like for example, this flower down here was really bright pink, and because it kind of down here in that right corner really was jumping out a little too much for me. Okay, so we're just going to tone that down a little bit. Okay, so you can see, look at that. Like just look, for example, look at the flower in the lower right. It's just less poppy. It takes too much attention down to the corner, I feel like. There we go. So let's look at overall before and after. Before, single raw. After, looking great. Okay. So let's go and export this, and then we'll look at them side by side in processing. It's trying to give it the same name. So let's throw a number one in there or something. Save. My armchair analysis right now is that the single raw looks just as good. I'm not sure. We'll do a comparison. But it sure was easier, and it sure was faster, and there's definitely no ghosting. Okay? All right? So, you know, if you've been doing something for years, always be willing to challenge what you think is true, you know? Just because you've always been doing 3 brackets or 5 brackets. I know some people that still say, like, I do 9 brackets all the time because it's the best. I'm like, well, okay. A lot of people just get stuck in what they think they know, right? Always be reanalyzing it, right? Not just with that, but everything in life. You know, they make up some theory and they just take it to the grave. There's a lot more ego in there than creativity, I think. Okay. Let's go do a side-by-side comparison. Okay. Bam. Let me delete that one. I don't know that. Okay, let's go over to processing. Look at them side-by-side. Okay. Side-by-side. Let me give them some good names so I actually know what it is. Okay, this is the raw. Okay, and this was the 3 exposure. Because otherwise I'll forget. Okay, this is the 3 exposure, and this is the raw. 3 exposure, raw. They're about the same, you know. I think I made the raw one a little darker. 3 exposure looks a little bit brighter, maybe more HDR-y. This one looks a little darker, maybe more realistic. And again, I process them differently, so it is a little apples and oranges, but you can see there's not a dramatic difference, right? We're really splitting hairs here. So on this one, let's go ahead and zoom in all the way and see if there's any ghosting. Looks like it's pretty good, actually. Oh, there's some people here that I'm going to get rid of with Content Aware. Looks pretty sharp, I must say. Okay, let's go look at the other one. I'm not zooming in. This, I think, is only zooming into 100%. This one does look sharper, for sure. There's a little less glow around the edges of these flowers. There's still tourist in this one. That's no surprise. Yeah. So, you know, once again, my analysis is I don't know which is better. I can't really tell. You know, to each their own. I think I'll go with this. I don't know. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to sit on it and, like, come back to it tomorrow and then decide which one of those I like better. Look, they're both winners. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. I can't go wrong. Okay, so don't, if you got two things that are winners, don't beat yourself up, right? They're both really good. So, and I think when I do a little bit of Photoshop, they'll look even better. All right, well, thank you for joining me on this grand adventure. I hope you enjoy the final shot. And once again, invite your friends, invite your family, get them to become Passport members. I think people that aren't even into photography enjoy watching this stuff. For example, I would watch Bob Ross all the time, and I don't really paint that much. It's just interesting to see an image come to life, you know. All right, thank you guys. I got your back 100%. Love you guys. And if you like this kind of stuff, let me know. We'll do even more. Okay, thanks from me and the Stuck in Customs team. You guys are awesome.